Hey guys, how's it going? Before we get into the video, I just wanted to show you guys what's happening internally in your motor, basically that's going to cause some of these symptoms. So what we have here is a cam lobe. This is going to rotate with your motor. And basically when this long portion of the lobe comes around, it's going to push your lifter and your push rod basically in the vertical direction here. As you can see, this push rod is going to basically pivot your rocker arm. And when this rocker arm pivots, it's going to compress your valve spring, opening up your valve. And so on the exhaust side of things, that's going to allow exhaust gases to flow out of your engine. And with the intake, it's going to allow oxygen to flow into your combustion chamber. So what happens is these rollers are going to roll along the surface of your cam lobe, and that's what's going to protect your camshaft from getting damaged. And so basically what happens with these rollers is there's needle bearings inside of these that allow it to roll without any play. And so when those needle bearings go bad, you get a lot of lash in your roller that's basically going to cause it to bounce in and out. And so when it does that, it's basically just going to be beating the surface of your camshaft until it's flat, and basically you won't have that vertical motion anymore. And so once that happens, your push rod won't be able to come up as much, and your valve spring won't compress nearly as much. And because of that, it's going to create a misfire, rough idle. It's going to cause a lot of issues, and not to mention, you know, metallic flakes in your oil, which nobody wants. So I'm not going to go into depth in this video why this occurs. There's a bunch of different theories out there, but really nothing's been proven yet. Some of the theories include MDS. The MDS system is, one thing that could have caused this. The overwhelming majority of the failures that we're seeing are happening to the MDS lifters. This could just be a bad lifter design. It could just be cheap materials. But some of the other theories that I've heard are the hardening of the cam was done incorrectly from the years 2011 and 2012, which is, where the majority of the failures that we're seeing occur. Also, I've heard a good theory online where basically the oil pressure is not high enough to basically the lifters in the cam that it protects it from wear. And seeing that some of the oil pressures on these rams get down to, 18 PSI at idle, I think that's, that definitely has a major role to play in why these failures occur. And so I'm going to show you guys in this video, how to solve a couple of these issues. So that way, hopefully we can kind of get these failures to stop happening in the future.
Thank you.
That's the bad one right there. See that?
Oh my god.
Oh jeez.
Oh god, Rick.
Oh jeez, god.
Oh. Oh great heavens!
Oh my god.
Oh my god, dude. What is that? That's so bad. Something I've never heard before.
Oh my god, bro.
Dude, what is that? That's just terrible.
And that was...
How is it only that one?
That's what I'm saying, bro. I mean, none of them look amazing. Like, dude, look at that one. That one is on its way out, bro.
That's bad. My cams don't even remotely look like that in the S4, bro.
And this one doesn't look great. Actually, a couple of them have some good wear on them.
Yep, it looks rightfully clapped.
All right.